Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John Gray, and we're just plain living here trying to see what we're doing. What are you doing, Peggy?
John, I'm trying to figure out what time it is.
The equipment's cold, just like we are.
Oh, God, it's freezing.
Huh?
It was freezing out there.
Freezing? It is freezing. It's below freezing. When the animals won't even go outside, when you look and you don't see squirrels and birds flying
but
around.
But it's turkey time at my house. Yesterday, I had 31 turkeys parading.
Oh, did you?
Parading around my house. So this morning, I thought, well, maybe it's because it was cold they were coming out. So I went out in the sunroom, and there was six. Not 31, though. That was just amazing.
They hunting. They hunting something to eat. They came out of the woods. They came out of the woods looking for sunshine. Is what they were doing.
I know. I love
them. Trying to warm up.
Once in a while, they'll have the big-tailed male turkeys, but usually it's just the ladies.
We were. I was building a subdivision up above Cool Springs Mall. It's called Val Verde, and at the end of this street there was a rock ledge. You know, probably 20 feet tall.
Yeah.
And that's where those turkeys would come down out of the woods, and they'd stand on that ledge and they'd just jump and flutter down to the ground.
Yeah.
And that was the males. The females stayed over in the woods. And so one day this little male, he comes down and he flutters down and he struts over there like that and he throws that little tail up.
Yeah.
And then here comes Grandpa. Grandpa comes down and walks right in front of him and throws that big tail out and runs that neck up in there and gobbles two or three times, and that little turkey just sort of trots off to the woods. Grandpa done showed him, you ain't ready yet.
Right. I love to watch them. I do.
Oh, animals. They're wonderful.
They're fascinating to me.
And the deer have changed color.
Why is that? Is that something, because they, of the
this time of year they get darker.
They get darker.
Their skin gets, their fur gets darker.
That.
And I guess that's to attract the sun.
My favorite visitor of animals was a little old tiny groundhog. He came up, I have a patio by the sunroom, and he came up to the door, which is glass, and he had his little paws up, and just looking everywhere, wanting to come in, and I thought, okay, I can catch that little guy.
They ugly though, aren't they?
I don't know, a little thing.
The little ones aren't, but boy, the big ones are.
I thought maybe I could catch him, but I opened the door and went off down the hill.
He didn't want no part of you. He didn't want no part of you. Hey, this is, I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving, and I hope
everybody was thankful.
Yes, and we talked about that, and I hope they were too. I guess probably by now the leftovers are gone.
Leftovers went home with the cooks from my house because I didn't do any cooking. They did the cooking,
I'm still cutting on a ham. Well, I'm taking, what I do is I strip that ham, and I've got a bone to take over to Roland Seagroves because Garth has two dogs. It's the only person I know with a big enough dog to eat a ham bone.
Eat a ham bone, yeah.
Most everybody's got those little powder puff dogs now, and they eat a ham bone bigger than they are.
I know.
So, but I strip it, and then I take and slice up what can be used for sandwich meat, put it in the freezer.
Did you boil it at all?
No, I didn't do a country ham this year. I just did a regular ham with pineapple and cloves.
I do love country ham, but it's got an awful lot of salt in it because, you know, it has to be salted.
You know how to do that? You want me to tell you how to do that?
Boil it in water.
Take you a pot that big. You got to have a pot big enough to put the ham in. Put the ham in there, fill it up with hot water out of the sink, and then turn the stove on and bring it to a boil. And you boil it for about 10 to 15 minutes.
And you just pour that off?
No, you just leave there. You turn the eye off. Take a bath towel, put it over the top of it, and leave it there all night.
And then what
happens? In the morning, you pour the water off, all of that salt's in that water.
Yeah.
Then you take it, then you put it in a roasting pan.
And cook it.
And put brown sugar and butter on it, and just let it, then let it cook.
Yeah, I don't do the brown sugar anymore. Sugar's bad for you.
Hell, nothing's bad for you once a year, Peggy.
I know.
You know, if you're like the Jamaicans and that's the only way you get sugar and you see them, none of them have any teeth left.
Right.
You know, or if they do, they're just dark brown. But no, I mean, once a year, twice a year for you to eat a little brown sugar ain't going to hurt anything.
I know, but I'm just careful with it.
Well, then don't put brown sugar on it.
Just put butter on it.
Pour molasses on it.
Well,
pour honey on it.
Honey's better. I think.
Pour honey on it. Honey's good for you.
I am still eating honey that my father's, were in my father's beehive, and he died in 2007.
How many gallons of honey did y'all have?
I don't know, but when my father died, Bart was home, and he went and robbed the bees for the last time, and he, you know, saved all the honey, and I'm still eating that honey. Isn't that great?
Oh, it's wonderful.
Not a day goes by I don't think about my father and his love of all things that made things you could eat or drink. You know, a farmer, that's what
sure,
they do.
A real farmer.
And
they had to do everything they could to grow and produce to make a living. You couldn't just depend on one crop.
Right.
You had to do other things.
To make a living and to stay alive, to have plenty to eat.
Yeah.
Which we did. We had
keep your house warm.
Yeah.
Did y'all have wood? Did y'all have fireplace in the house?
We did, and we didn't have electricity until I was about maybe 9 years old. So I know all about doing without.
Candlelight.
Yeah, candlelight.
Oil lamps.
The whole thing.
Oil lamps. See, that's one thing I don't like it when the power goes off because it might stay off a long time.
Right.
And none of us, aren't set up for that. But when the power's off, it snows real big. Power's off for a day, and you at night, you walk down the street, and the glow that's coming out of the houses is different. It's not that bright white or blue light. It's a yellow light from oil lamps or candles.
Exactly.
And it just looks so peaceful. And it's so quiet.
And it can be so cold.
Speaking about that, I'm going to read a couple of things today. We were thankful. We're still thankful. But we're looking forward to the Christmas season. This is something I wrote, and I've read it many times before, but it's appropriate for now. There was a lady in this town called Annie Mears, and Annie Mears was a bag woman.
Okay.
She'd go push a grocery cart around.
I think I remember.
And she was a big, tall. She was a tall, straight-backed lady. And when I looked at her, I'd think, you know, there's something noble, something royal looking about her.
I always wondered. I sat down beside her. She was on a bench. I hadn't been here too long. And she was sitting on a bench. And I went over and sat beside her. And I said, can I sit with you? And she said, sure. But we talked. And as we talked, I realized she was a lot of substance to her. She was very bright. And I wanted to ask questions about why she was where she was.
You know, when you think if life would have turned a different way just a little bit, what she might have been on the other side of it. Because she was never saw her hunkered over. She was always straight back. So this is what I wrote. Annie is noble, but nobody knows. She wanders down alleys in ragged old clothes, her cart half filled with aluminum cans. A modern-day savage who lives off the land. Her backboard straight, her head always high. A whisper of royalty gleams in her eye. Depending on no one, she goes on her own. The smile on her face shows she's never alone. Now, we've turned this world into a real crazy place. We all run around at a breakneck pace. The clubs, the meetings, no price is too high. And when we see Annie, our heads turn with a sigh. A smile on her face, that gleam in her eye, she stops and thinks, but for the grace of God, there go I. So who is the winner in life's the great game, the banker, the lawyer, the holder of fame? or Annie the noble who passes alone and with dignity stands by the side of the throne. She watches us flounder, our sight set so high, and thinks, but for the grace of God, there go I. Annie was noble, but nobody knew. Just not enough time, just too much to do.
And nobody knew any background or anything
no.
about her. That's sad.
But she was noble.
Yeah. That's nice what you wrote. I like it.
For all of you who wander through this life through times of sadness, times of sorrow, times of wonder, will I get through? It's the walk you walk that marks the man, not a hollow word's echo or a falsely gripped hand. Not which bistro you frequent. It's not where you shop or the number you step on to get to the top. It's not the money you gather, not the houses or cars. When it's all said and done, you'll be judged by the scars. The stitches you got from helping a friend. The bruises you carry from making amends. The tears on a heart where love's freely given. The scrapes and the scratches that just come from living. The pain that you bear for the good of a stranger. As you walk straight in and grin at the danger. When most step aside and watch from afar. Know that in the end you'll be judged by the scars. When life knocks you down, how do you react? You crawl, scratch, and stumble to find your way back up a road you can conquer when you start on your knees. With a new strength of character born in adversity, as you touch all those you pass, no matter who they are. Because when it's all said and done, you'll be judged by the scars. It's not that you're pretty. It's not that you're smart. But your depth of compassion and the size of your heart that you share with others, whoever they are. Because when it's all said and done, you'll be judged by the scars.
It's very good. All said and done, judged by the scars. When did you write that?
I wrote that after Jacob's accident. That was 2001. That was pretty much for him.
That was a heavy time for your family, I know.
Yeah, it was a hard time, tough time. Noel.
Noel.
Noel, Noel.
Noel,
Noel.
God, I couldn't get up there.
Born is the King of Israel.
Little harmony.
If the first Noel was this Christmas Eve, what would it take for you to believe? When he comes, how would you know? Not from the TV, newspaper, or radio, because it wouldn't be in a castle or a mansion uptown, but a mission shelter where the homeless are found. So what would it take for you to understand that just outside your comfort zone is born the Son of Man? Will you believe the rumors and the stories strangers tell? Will you hear the angels sing at the next Noel? Or will you be too busy and so self-absorbed that you miss the greatest gift to man from our Lord, the Son and the Savior that was sent for you and me? So open your heart, be part of the history. That's what it will take for you to understand that just outside your comfort zone is born the Son of Man. If you believe and search beyond what the pundits sell, you will hear the angels sing at the next Noel. Just believe. He was conceived to shoulder all life's hell. And you will hear the angels sing at the next Noel.
Very pretty, very Christmassy.
So, we're at the beginning of the Christmas season.
All right, let's run through it if we can remember. The lighting of the Christmas tree at South Jackson Performing Arts Center, is that?
That's Thursday night. RJ and Sandy Hayes
will be honored, and there will be a little reception.
Grand Marshals.
And what time does it start?
I think it's at 7. Well, it's going to be, I don't know.
It could be a lot earlier.
Probably earlier than that because it gets dark about 5:30. I know the Christmas parade starts at 7.
Thursday?
Friday night.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Friday night.
Thursday night is just the reception.
Right, because
the lighting of the tree.
We did have the reception before the parade, but getting everybody in and out of South Jackson for two separate events.
It's too much.
Is not the, so that's why they're doing it on Thursday.
I think that's a good
to
idea.
To give plenty of time to celebrate RJ and Sandy or whoever the Grand Marshals
right.
are. So, and know that we'll be playing that live. We also filmed the Manchester Christmas Parade Friday. We'll be working on that, and that possibly will be on the air toward the end of the week. And then we will do the Tullahoma Christmas Parade live, and then it will run. Both of them will run all month this month, numerous times.
Good, so everybody will get to see it. And remember, if you don't have Charter TV or LightTube, you can see it on YouTube.
Yep, YouTube, our YouTube channel. The link on Channel 6.
Channel 6.
The link.
Either
way one.
Works. Okay.
But the 6 is a 6, not spell 6. It's
right.
the number 6.
It's the number 6.
So with all of that said, we got a bunch of stuff to... Oh, what?
I want to mention...
Becky Buller?
Becky Buller is coming Saturday night.
No.
Is it Sunday?
Sunday.
Yeah, Sunday.
This week.
7:00.
7:00, Sunday
South
night.
Jackson, yes. Tickets are going fast, so get out there and get you a ticket.
She's brilliant. She's wonderful, wonderful,
and
wonderful.
It's a special show. It's a Christmas show.
Yeah, and Romy's going to be there. I hope her hunky husband, Jeff, will be there. That's what she calls him,
yeah.
My hunky husband. I love it.
It's a great.
Becky's such a sweetheart.
She's so talented.
Very,
she
very,
writes
very.
Her own music.
She has about, 10 or 12 IBMA awards and a Grammy.
So I'm glad she's here anyway.
Yeah, she'll be here.
Throw that out there.
And we probably have some video from her today as well.
I think we do, yeah.
But we have a lot of stuff going on, and we're going to take a quick commercial break, and we'll be back with the rest of the show.
I want to invite y'all to come by Clayton's, downtown Tullahoma. We try to serve the community, the area, and we try to help people with their feet and comfortable shoes. We still measure feet. We have a great new arch mat. We have insoles. Please come see us at Clayton's and let me help you find some comfortable shoes for those achy feet.
My husband was diagnosed with a spinal infection. He lost his ability to swallow and the movement of his legs.
I couldn't turn over in bed. I couldn't walk. I couldn't eat.
They were just wonderful in the treatment and care they gave my husband.
I regained my mobility where I was able to go home.
It is miraculous.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
STEM is everywhere. Like here, behind the scenes of The Walking Dead.
When we break down clothes, we tumble it with trisodium phosphate, rock salt, and dish detergent.
We stitched together images of our model and created a 3D set that can be walked through in a VR headset.
We're able to turn 12 walkers into 1,000 walker boards.
STEM can create new worlds on and off the screen. What will you make with STEM? Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop with Stroop's Accurate Refrigeration, your number one hometown HVAC company. We offer dependable and reliable service on all your HVAC equipment. We also offer high-efficiency trained cooling units. Call us for your cooling needs. Your comfort is what we do.
It's summer, call Stroop!
People in Tennessee are starting a movement.
Ouch. Thank you.
To clean up the litter on our roadways. Litter hurts our environment and endangers wildlife, and it affects our quality of life.
Here, grab me. Thank you.
Help keep our state litter free.
Let's roll.
Visit NobodyTrashesTennessee.com and be a part of the solution to end littering.
Saving the best for last.
That's right. Nobody Trashes Tennessee.
All right.
ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We're glad to have with us today on the show Mr. Jim Waters. And Jim is one of these folks that's done a whole lot of stuff around town. He's a businessman, he's been a politician, been an alderman, done a lot of stuff. And one of the things he does is he helps people with their insurance. And you know, now that we've got all these different types of plans and insurance and stuff, and a lot of people who are on Medicare, whatever they're doing, they've got a certain date, like in December, I think it's what, the 7th?
7th, yes sir.
7th, that you've got to figure out what you're gonna do and get it done.
That's right.
And Jim wants to talk to you a little bit today about some of the things, the plans that he has, and the fact that if you go past that, there's things you can do, right?
Right, right.
Well, you know, tell our audience up there things that you can do for them and things that they really might not know about that you need to make sure they do know.
Well, you know, this is called AEP, Annual Enrollment Period, and it starts October the 15th and goes through December the 7th. Then after that, starting January the 1st to April 1st, you have something called OEP, Open Enrollment. So if you've got something you don't like, you can change. And there's all kinds of different plans out there. What I do most of all is Advantage plans. And most Advantage plans are zero premium. And you get your doctor, you go to your doctor free. You have a prescription drug plan. You go to a specialist anywhere from $25 to $35. Have one plan, it's called a give back plan, and you get back $105. They give you back on your Part B premium. Your Part B premium is like $175 this year. I've been told it's going to be $180 to $185 next year. So if you get that plan, you would only pay about $80. So that's another benefit you could get from being on this insurance. I've been doing it about eight years, I guess. And there's two kinds of Medicare plans. There's one called a Medigap, and that's where you have a premium. And with the premium, you also have a prescription drug plan you have to pay money for, which is a premium. Or you can go with the Advantage plan, and you get your the doctors, and you get your hospitals, and you get your prescription drugs all in one plan. And you see them talk about Plan C on TV. That's what that is. You take A, B, and D and couple it all together, and you get C. And of course, like I said previously, it's those plans are, I don't know of one, well, there is some that's more than zero, but most premium is zero. But you know, there I know one that's $86 a month, but most people do the zero premium. And I can't mention the kind of companies I work for. I think that might be against Medicare rules, so I have to be careful what I say. But I do it because I enjoy helping people. I've always helped people. That's my thing in life. And I do quite well with it. I serve Coffee County, Moore County, Bedford County, Warren County, White County, all of this area, Rutherford County. I serve this whole area of people that's interested in getting Medicare insurance. So, you know, anybody I can help, I'd like to help them. It's more of helping than it is anything else, because I make a little money out of it. But it's a fun thing for me, because I help a lot of people that don't know anything about it, and I try to guide them in the right direction. And I try to save people a lot of money. My goal is to get them a real good health plan and save them a lot of money. And people tend to like that. And
Well, I bet they do.
That's what everybody wants.
Everybody wants that. Now, the most important thing, though, that what you've said, and I know a lot of these television ads say, now, you've got to have this done. You've got to have this done. You've got to have this done by so-and-so. But you're telling us that even though you do pick a plan before the 7th, you've got some other time to look back through that again when you start using it and go, wait a minute, this isn't working for me.
That's exactly right. You can do it one time, and it's anywhere from January till April the 1st. And like I said, it's called OEP, or Open Enrollment Period.
Open Enrollment.
And so all you have to do is contact me or contact a person that does this, and they can help you. Now, if you go from a Medigap plan to a Advantage plan, and you decide you don't like that Advantage plan, Well, let me back up. If you go from a Medigap plan to an Advantage plan, if you decide you don't like that Advantage plan, you can go back to the Medigap plan. You got 1 year to that date, or within the year, from January 1st to December 31st, to go back to that plan.
Right.
And they can't, you know, they might say you can't do it, but the law says they have to. That's a Medicare law.
That's Medicare law. So if someone wants to get in touch with you, because you've given us a lot of good information, but it's nothing like sitting down with somebody and really get in depth and explaining it to them. How does somebody get in touch with you, Jim?
They just call me on my telephone. I've got a cell phone, and you can call me day or night, 24/7 if you need to. And it's 931-247-4530.
All right.
And I ran some ads this year for people just to know how to get a hold of me.
Okay.
It's in the Tullahoma News and the Shelbyville Gazette, because I failed to say Bedford County maybe. And it's in Warren County News. I have a lot of clients in Warren County.
Very good, very good. Well, Jim, I hope you had a good Thanksgiving, and I hope you have a wonderful holiday season. Look forward to a big Christmas and rest a little bit.
Well, I appreciate you letting me do this, because it's important to me, because I feel like I'm doing something worthwhile.
All right. Mr. Jim Waters. Thank you, my friend.
You're welcome.
You be safe out there and have a good Christmas, okay, buddy?
Thank you, Mr. John.
All right, man, you got it. We'll be back after these messages.
Hi, my name is Ringo. Here at Barkview Senior Living, they're human-friendly. That's why I love it here, and so does my senior human. When they want a bite, they get chef-prepared meals, and so do I. Movies in the theater, day trips, walks on the trail, and other senior humans to play with. The grass and the grounds are exquisite. It's everything my human needs to be healthy and active. Barkview. A Parkview Senior Living. For your dog's best friend, you.
Every day, thousands of kids start vaping. And I can't let this happen to my kid. Of course, it's awkward to talk to your kids about the dangers of vaping.
Hey, bestie. How sketch is me?
It's hard to get their attention.
Ready? Go. Yes. Look at that.
Yeah, you didn't turn yours over. So if you want to talk to your kids about the dangers of vaping, you got to get it trending.
No, you're doing it wrong.
Let's go.
Can we talk?
Yeah, what's up?
Visit talkaboutvaping.org for tips on when and how to have the vape talk.
We teach Parkinson's patients how to move big and not let the Parkinson's slow them down. I've had patients I've treated in-house that could not even stand up, could not roll over in the bed, left the facility walking with a walker, have come back to us as outpatient and continued their big program, and are now completely, handling life. The success of the program is just phenomenal.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Hi, I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you prevent wildfires.
Dude, I've got this. I've been camping since I was 5 years old.
But I am a camping influencer.
You know what? I'll bet you $5.
Okay.
Assistant Smokey, what is the best way to put out a campfire?
Mm-hmm.
To put out a campfire, drown with water, stir, drown again. Then make sure the fire is out cold by feeling with the back of your hand.
Wait, really?
I'll take the $5.
Hey, Tennessee. Ross Chastain here, the guy who likes to smash watermelons on the front stretch at Nashville Super Speedway. But you know what I never smash? Safety rules. Racing's all about control, and the same goes for life on the road. So use your melon and don't mix drinking and driving. It's like trying to race with a busted engine. Be a pit crew hero. And if you've had a few, pass the keys to a sober friend, because we're all racing toward a safer Tennessee, and we want you there at the finish line.
Recently at South Jackson Performing Arts Center, we had this wonderful showcase of young musicians, and if you don't know what the Young Musicians Showcase is, it's students in high school in Tullahoma of various teachers around town. And we presented all these students on stage on the 24th of November, and it was quite successful. Today, we're honored to have a video of Ben Mihalik, and he is playing the first movement of a sonatina by Ravel. And we'll show that now.
Please welcome to the stage Ben Mihalik as he plays the first movement of the sonatina by Ravel.
Thank you. smoking tobacco accounts for 3 of every 10 fire deaths in the United States.
Tullahoma Fire Department, Tullahoma Fire Department, need you en route to a structure fire, 202 Main Street, heavy smoke showing. Neighbors advise child trapped inside.
Lighters, matches, and associated smoking paraphernalia are the leading cause of preschooler fire deaths. We as firefighters know that most structure fires can be prevented.
I've got one.
Command, this is primary search. We have a victim. Need EMS to meet us at the front door.
Please, help us to give you a fighting chance. This can be prevented. Contact the Tullahoma Fire Department for a free home safety inspection.
What's a Tennessee vacation? It starts off like any road trip, and then, boom, adventure and thrills everywhere you look, which happens to be some of the most beautiful scenery in the country. Music here, history there, and all kinds of green in between. Come relax and unwind, or bring the crowd for some stargazing, or stargazing. Whatever you do, come hungry and expect an awesome soundtrack. It's all right here in Tennessee. We're playing your song. For a free vacation guide, visit tnvacation.com.
Come on. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. Yeah.
You're not going to get it all right. Just make sure you nail the big stuff, like making sure your kids are in the right seat for their age and size.
Yeah.
Get it right at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Talking history about this and that. It's Conversations with John and Pat, with John and Pat, with John and Pat.
Hello, everyone. I'm John Rigman.
And I'm Pat Welch. And, John, we are here today for segment 72 of the Conversations with John and Pat.
We're just so glad to be here.
Absolutely.
Wrote this song several years ago. It's a parody, by the way.
Okay.
You know, we've
discussed the meaning of that.
It's a tune that Mac Davis came up with, and he had different words, and I kind of changed them for our little musical trio. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. We can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause we get better looking each day. To know us is to love us. We must be a heck of a band. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble, but we're doing the best that we can. Once we had an agent, but he never did nothing for us. He charged us a fee for our tryout, then never did get back in touch. Do you reckon he lost our phone number, or by accident throwed it away? I bet he's perturbed, 'cause talent like ours just don't come along every day. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. We can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause we get better looking each day. To know us is to love us. We must be a heck of a band. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble, but we're doing the best that we can. You ask why we're not on the Opry. It's a fact many people don't know. Roy Acuff has personally called us, but we've just been too busy to go. Some people say that we're conceited, but we don't even know what that means. But I think it has something to do with the way we're affected by eating white beans. I can't believe I wrote that. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble, when you're perfect in every way. We can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause we get better looking each day. To know us is to love us. We must be a heck of a band. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble, but we're doing the best that we can. You know, that's silly.
There's
silly
a whole lot song I could say about that, John, but I'm going to refrain.
I know it. Phil Comstock, I wrote it, and then I let Phil sing it, and he sings that last part, and that's not so embarrassing to me when he does it.
That's exactly
but then
right,
the lyrics are there for me to sing. And did you know how long that song's been written? Roy Acuff was still alive. It's been a long time.
Yeah.
Y'all, we're going to talk about the THS boys basketball team of 1978-79. You guys on that team, y'all get ready to hear about yourselves. The team was coached by Dale Phelps. Let's put their picture up there, Philip. And they lost to Knoxville Farragut in the quarterfinals, 60-55. Only THS team to go as far. Took the district and regional tournament in sub-state. They squeaked by Bradley County, 74-73 in overtime. The team consisted of, and here's the way it go, managers David Cooley, Freddie Fox down front, standing on the left, Coach Phelps, Scott Simpson, Robert Hayes, David Hollinshed, Eugene London, Odell Crutchfield, Seth McDonald, Alex Sharpton, Tim Lim Telford, Bobby Phelps, and that's the coach's son. He was a playmaker. Frank Johnson, Daryl Gillum, and Joe Johnson. Now let's show Seth. Seth was a big man. He was 6'7", and averaged 15.3 points a game. This team, by the way, had a 24-3 record, and the scoring was led by Seth. But not too far behind him was Odell Crutchfield. Put his picture up if you would.
John, you come prepared today, buddy. I'm proud of you.
Well, I saw the way you did last segment, and I decided I'd try to do better.
It didn't take a lot of effort to do that, too.
Just kidding. I've got a paper in front of me. That's easier this way. And Odell had 7-point average. And then Frank Johnson, he's our next one to show. Frank Johnson was a guy I taught over at East and coached. He was a great guy for me and for Coach Phelps as well. 13 points a game. And Frank and Odell were chosen on the district tournament team, joined by Bobby Phelps and Frank in the regional team. Daryl Gillum did not miss a free throw in the tournament play. And Alex Sharpton and Lim Telford were strong substitutes at 6'3", which signified a team effort throughout the entire season. And they were a great team. And one of the assets of the team is having, when you play defense with a large bunch of guys, and Seth was a center, inside meaning was you have always had to keep him, compress your defense to make sure that you've got him contained. And Odell, then again, he had height enough mm-hmm. to do the same. And some of the other guys were.
Eugene would have too.
Yeah. And all those guys had height. And that's probably one reason that team went on to as far as they did in the season. And they were, again, sub-state, they squeaked by Bradley County 74-73, went to state finals, and they were in the quarterfinals of the state. So they had a real good team, and they should be congratulated.
Did you say Bradley won that the tournament that year?
Bradley County, they squeaked by Bradley County.
Okay, who? Farragut.
Farragut won, okay. Lost Farragut in the. And I'm not sure, it doesn't say that Farragut won the entire tournament, but it was a great
group of guys and a great season. And I know those guys are proud.
And should be.
To be a part of that team even now.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's pretty much our segment today, and we're happy to be here. And Pat, you got anything you'd like to say?
John, I'm still reeling from a bad performance the previous week on that one that you alluded to there.
Oh, you did good. I was just pulling your leg.
Your annual, we'll have to talk to the annual staff.
I'd like to add just one little comment before we finish up here. Not too long ago, I told the story about Charlie Saunders, teacher at East, and Tim Stubblefield wrestling at East. And I was the referee, student, and teacher wrestling, and all the students gathering around. And I had told that Tim got Mr. Saunders down and so
you
I
ruined
made him
illegal hole.
I made him stand back up because of the legal hole. Well, I got a call from Mr. Saunders just the other day. He's leading singing, by the way, over at Highland Baptist Church, and some of his church folks had told him I told that tale. And he said, "I want you to know that I got Tim down, and then you made a stand back up." And by the time I stood back up and had to go at him again, I was so tired I couldn't do anything.
that's a better story.
We try to be accurate with our information, but, 40 years does something to your memory.
Oh, man. Well, I imagine it probably jaded Tim's, too, because I don't think I doubt Tim remembers him getting taken out by Mr. Saunders either.
No, good fellas and a good basketball team at that time.
It was
a
great team.
Thank you, everyone.
And that is closes out segment 72, but it's not the end of the story. We hope if management allows to come back, we've got the stories. Thank y'all.
Talking history about this and that. It's Conversations with John and Pat, with John and Pat, with John and Pat.
The Bookshelf in Tullahoma is the fundraising arm of the Coffee County Literacy Council. Since 1988, the Literacy Council's goal and purpose has been to support and promote adult basic education in Coffee County. We enable individuals to complete their high school equivalency exam, which helps them get better jobs or continue into higher education. The Bookshelf at 114 Southwest Atlantic Street in Tullahoma is where we sell used books, which are donated to us by the community. Come see us. Bring your books to donate and join us as you find every genre of books that you can imagine.
I had a knee replacement, so they've got me in Life Care, which I'm very, very thankful for. I couldn't garden. I couldn't do my flower beds. I can't chase my little dogs. I have been in several therapy sessions for knees and back, and that's the best therapist I believe I've ever been to. It's tremendous because I'm able to walk again, but if it wasn't for the care, I wouldn't be where I am.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Is this the year you want to get fit? If so, check out just some of the things Tullahoma Parks and Rec has to offer. Kickboxing, aerobics, silver sneakers workouts, swim lessons, boot camp, water aerobics, basketball, Zumba, yoga, pickleball, lap swimming, treadmill, karate. Get fit, Tullahoma, and have some fun with Tullahoma Parks and Rec. Independent senior living at its finest.
Do you love sports? Then you should know about STEM. Because maximizing nutrition, analyzing peak muscle performance, calculating the perfect shot, and more are all made possible by science, technology, engineering, and math. In fact, there are more careers than ever in sports science. So if you have a passion for sports, then think about getting involved in STEM and improve everyone's game on and off the field. Get inspired at SheCanSTEM.com.
All right, we're back, and you know we're into the season here, and we you know you can still get into the get an ad on the Tullahoma and Manchester Christmas Parade. It's $100 for each one of them. Plays probably 20 times plus in the month of December this
That's
month.
That's great, yeah.
And then, or if you get both of them, it's 150 for both of them.
So if you get a commercial, you're talking about getting a commercial? Or
yeah, it's a commercial. It's and, a full commercial.
Is it acted? Is it, how do they do it?
Well, we just film a commercial. Most of our sponsors already have commercials.
Okay.
But if we need to film a commercial for somebody, we will.
Okay.
Or we'll invite them on the set,
out how
you know.
It would be done if it was just, they just called in Thursday night and you didn't have time to
We'd talk about them.
Talk about it, okay.
We'd invite them up on the set.
That's great.
You know, and let them show up on during the parade. So, you know, anybody, that's my phone number is 931-581-5238, or you can stop by here. And we're at 207 North Jackson Street, right in between Roper's Lawnmower and Tri-County Bank.
And do you all still do this out front on the porch?
It'll be on the front porch. We'll have our area roped off out there because we need to have cameras and
right.
camera people working on our parking lot and we'll have it all lit up, and Candy and Jimmy will be out there. I got a brand new heater to put under the table.
Oh, good.
Keep them warm. So, yeah, we can't have our co-host getting cold.
Oh, it's hard to keep talking when your teeth are chattering.
So, but this is the Manchester Christmas Parade right here. Andrew was over there the other night, and this is just a little taste of that. You know, this is the end of it. That must be Santa Claus right there in the sleigh. And, but we'll show that this parade in their entirety. Narrated. There's old Santa Claus up there. It's kind of dark, but he'll show up.
Is that his sled?
Yeah, got reindeer. Look, that must be Miss Claus. No, is that a dog or a woman?
Merry Christmas.
Might be both. That's Miss Claus. No, she's not a dog.
That's quite a fancy float.
Yeah, that's a fancy sleigh.
Do you know how many floats do you have in the Christmas parade?
Our Christmas parade probably got about 100 entries in it at least.
Wow, I think that's amazing.
Yep. And it's going to start at South Jackson and end at Tullahoma High School. So on Friday night, if you're trying to get up and down Jackson Street after when it starts getting dark, you ain't gonna make it. You're gonna have to go some other way. I imagine they'll route people around either on Atlantic Street or down Cedar Lane.
Cedar Lane, y'all.
But it's that time of year, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, one thing we want to remind you of as well is shop local.
Oh, yeah. There's plenty of stuff here in town.
You know, we got all kinds of stuff in town. Don't get in your car and head to Atlanta, head to Nashville, head to Chattanooga until you check around here.
That's true.
You might find what you want right here. And, you know,
there's the Chris Kendall Mart going on at South Jackson. What day is
yeah,
that?
The Christmas trees of South Jackson are going on down there right now, so you can go in and look at the trees.
And they'll be there.
They'll be there throughout the holiday season.
I think they open up.
I think it's $10. It's a fee.
It was $5. Maybe it's gone.
Maybe it's $5. I don't know. But it's a modest fee because it takes a lot of time and a lot of money to make that happen. So it's always good to see if you can generate a little money just to break even. Be nice to make a little profit every now and then.
Right.
So yeah, there's old Santa Claus right there. Downtown Manchester looks like they decorated up pretty good. They over to Christmas tree lighting.
Do they have us on?
Huh?
Are we being broadcast or do we just listen
both
to that? Oh, okay. Looks like they had a good crowd.
Yeah, they had a good crowd. It's always fun. There'll be kids out here. There'll be, you know, I don't know whether they're going to pass candy out or not. Usually they wouldn't let you throw candy, and then it got to where they're saying, oh, well, it might hit some kid in the eyes. And, you know, we're so protective of everybody right now, you can't do anything.
Well, and then you're afraid that the wrong person will be throwing candy that has fentanyl in it.
Well, that's true. But, I mean, if they're in the Christmas parade, they shouldn't be. You shouldn't be, but you never can tell. That's sort of like Halloween. You can't take fresh baked brownies anymore.
Oh, and it's kind of sad, isn't it?
Well, we used to go down Miss Wagner's house at the end of Druid Lane. She'd make the best cupcakes. Oh, it'd have that icing on it and everything. Everybody wanted to go to Miss Wagner's house.
I bet she.
But now you can't do that because you're afraid somebody's gonna put broken glass in them and.
Poison or
Miss Wagner wouldn't do that.
She
wouldn't do that. But you know, you never know now. You know, people don't go. People come to Tullahoma to go to certain streets here because that's where they think they can get a better candy.
Right.
And they'll come from Winchester and Shelbyville and
line up
to go down two or three different streets in town.
They'll look for where the most lights are.
Most lights are.
And the.
Best bar candy.
Right.
What's your favorite candy? You don't eat candy, do you?
I really don't. I love it. I mean, I love dark chocolate. My favorite candy, I guess, is chocolate.
Chocolate, yeah. Did you like taffy? You know, like...
Sticky, right?
Yeah, saltwater taffy.
Yeah.
Stick to your teeth.
I know. Yeah, I've eaten that.
Yeah.
My grandmother used to make taffy. It was the most fun. We would be out.
You had to pull it, didn't you?
Yeah, we had to pull it. And we'd be outside, and my sister and a cousin or two, we'd be pulling taffy and hanging it on the clothesline. It would be everywhere. And then it would get dry and you break it up. It was fun.
Yeah. Now, did your daddy whittle?
And by the way, we didn't worry about washing our hands.
Did your daddy whittle?
My dad didn't have time to whittle.
Well, I mean, that's what I was asking. You know, a lot of times you see a bunch of old guys sitting around, they got a stick, you know, and they whittling.
You can see that at Lynchburg.
Your daddy's farm.
A lot of whittling in
He didn't whittle. Was he musical?
No.
He didn't play a guitar harmonica or anything like that?
Didn't have time to play.
But where'd you get it? Was your mama musical?
She wanted to be. And so she put all she had into my sister and me so that we could be musicians. And I think she loved music. She loved the sound of it. And my dad liked it too.
Yeah.
But my grandparents did music, and I lived with them a lot.
Yeah, okay.
When I was little, but my grandfather played a banjo.
Uh-huh.
And it was an interesting banjo. It didn't have the same number of strings that they have now.
Right.
I don't know if he made it or what. But
he might have.
He might have, because that was a long time ago.
Good job.
Good job. All right, we're ready to go. That's enough useless drivel. What we're going to do is we're going to take a break. Everybody come to the Christmas parade. It's this Friday night. Go down to South Jackson on Thursday night for the grand opening of the Grand Marshal celebration and the lighting of the Christmas tree at South Jackson.
The
trees of Christmas inside the building as well. You'll be able to go through that at the reception for the Grand Marshal.
And everybody's invited.
Everybody's invited.
Come so, have a good time. Bring your mama
We'll
down.
See you outside on the Christmas parade night. We'll be right here at our location, live and wired and ready to roll. So be safe, be careful, and be kind to one another, and shop local, shop local, shop local. Thank you. We'll be seeing you next time.
Oh, are we not finished?
Are we not finished?
Oh, okay.
Just commercial.
Yeah.
I want to invite y'all to come by Clayton's, downtown Tullahoma. We try to serve the community, the area, and we try to help people with their feet and comfortable shoes. We still measure feet. We have a great new arch mat. We have insoles. Please come see us at Clayton's and let me help you find some comfortable shoes for those achy feet.
My husband was diagnosed with a spinal infection. He lost his ability to swallow and the movement of his legs.
I couldn't turn over in bed. I couldn't walk. I couldn't eat.
They were just wonderful in the treatment and care they gave my husband.
I regained my mobility where I was able to go home.
It is miraculous.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
STEM is everywhere. Like here, behind the scenes of The Walking Dead.
When we break down clothes, we tumble it with trisodium phosphate, rock salt, and dish detergent.
We stitched together images of our model and created a 3D set that can be walked through in a VR headset.
We're able to turn 12 walkers into 1,000 walker boards.
STEM can create new worlds on and off the screen. What will you make with STEM? Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop with Stroop's Accurate Refrigeration, your number one hometown HVAC company. We offer dependable and reliable service on all your HVAC equipment. We also offer high-efficiency trained cooling units. Call us for your cooling needs. Your comfort is what we do.
It's summer, call Stroop!
People in Tennessee are starting a movement.
Ouch. Thank you.
To clean up the litter on our roadways. Litter hurts our environment and endangers wildlife, and it affects our quality of life.
Here, grab me. Thank you.
Help keep our state litter free.
Let's roll.
Visit NobodyTrashesTennessee.com and be a part of the solution to end littering.
Saving the best for last.
That's right. Nobody trashes Tennessee.
All you wonderful people in TV land, thank you for that introduction, John, and our camera ladies, good morning to all y'all, and it's a beautiful day. And you know, one of the parts of history that's part of everybody's life and has been forever and still continues to be, and that is the grocery stores in Tullahoma. Grocery stores. I was raised in a grocery store. Cut my baby teeth on a potato hamper when I was growing up. But you know, in the 100 block of North Atlantic and the 100 block of West Lincoln and the two blocks that joined them both ways 20 years ago, you could get anything you need in the way of groceries, your car repairs, your gasoline, clothes, dime stores, hardware stores, the whole works. And now, with the changing of time and growth and progress, of course, people walked all the time back then, and they would get their goods right downtown. And the mobile society that we live in today, people go everywhere in their cars to shop or for pleasure or for whatever. But back to groceries. Some people thought the first Kroger store was over where the Dollar General store is on South Atlantic Street. But the truth of the matter is the first Kroger store was located where the Tennessee Shoe Repair is. On Atlantic, 100 block of North Atlantic Street. Next door to it was on the north side was H.G. Hill. And toward the back was where Daddy Billy's is located now, was W.J. Couch and Company. And that was one of the earliest grocery stores downtown in Tullahoma. Mr. Moat Ross had a grocery store over on Lincoln Street. Bill Jones later had one on Lincoln and South Jackson Street. One of the first drive-in grocery stores was the S.W. Stone's, a store on Wilson Avenue. I believe it was called a Minute Saver. And Speedy Sack or Speedy's was Bill Tipps over on West Lincoln Street. And then they had a little bitty grocery stores like Marvin Sawyer's store on Hogan Street, where the used to be a drugstore on that location. But they made a great contribution to Tullahoma. Early grocery stores had delivery service and had credit. But now, you know, in our society today, almost everything that we buy is prepackaged or you got to pay for it before you get it. You know, this time of year traditionally has been the time of year when crystallized fruit came to the grocery stores for ladies to make fruitcakes for Thanksgiving and Christmas. And all that fruit came in big pine boxes wrapped in wax paper. And the cherries and the pineapple and the apples and all that sort of thing came that way. But now everything is prepackaged. We weighed up corn and we weighed up flour and meal and beans and the whole works, potatoes, but now all of it is prepackaged. Let me quickly give you, if you are old enough to remember, that we ground and roasted our own coffee at Daddy Billy's grocery store and sold it for 10 cents a pound and 3 pounds for a quarter. The potatoes were a 20-pound bag for a quarter, and sorghum was 50 cents a gallon. Veal chops, 15 cents a pound. Let's see. You know, one of the highest priced products today is postages and cereal, but 1934, you get two big boxes of cereal for a quarter. Those were good days, you know, but of course, money has changed a whole lot. And get real hungry, go to the grocery store and get your load of groceries and enjoy them. And this is not the end of the story, because there's a whole lot more to come. We thank you for watching, and we'll be seeing you next week with a whole lot more. Thank you, and everybody have a good day.
My name is Ringo. Here at Barkview Senior Living, they're human friendly. That's why I love it here, and so does my senior human. When they want a bite, they get chef-prepared meals, and so do I. Movies in the theater, day trips, walks on the trail, and other senior humans to play with. The grass and the grounds are exquisite. It's everything my human needs to be healthy and active. Barkview. A Parkview Senior Living. For your dog's best friend, you.
Every day, thousands of kids start vaping. And I can't let this happen to my kid. Of course, it's awkward to talk to your kids about the dangers of vaping.
Hey, bestie. How sketches, baby?
It's hard to get their attention.
Ready? Go. Yes. Look at that. Yeah, you didn't even turn yours over.
So if you want to talk to your kids about the dangers of vaping, you got to get it trending.
No, you're doing it wrong.
Let's go.
Can we talk?
Yeah, what's up?
Visit talkaboutvaping.org for tips on when and how to have the vape talk.
We teach Parkinson's patients how to move big and not let the Parkinson's slow them down. I've had patients I've treated in-house that could not even stand up, could not roll over in the bed, left the facility walking with a walker, have come back to us in outpatient and continued their big program, and are now completely, you know, handling life. The success of the program is just phenomenal.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Hi, I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you prevent wildfires.
Dude, I've got this. I've been camping since I was 5 years old.
But I am a camping influencer.
You know what? I'll bet you $5.
Okay.
Assistant Smokey, what is the best way to put out a campfire?
Mm-hmm.
To put out a campfire, drown with water, stir, drown again, then make sure the fire is out cold by feeling with the back of your hand.
Wait, really?
I'll take the $5.
Hey, Tennessee, Ross Chastain here, the guy who likes to smash watermelons on the front stretch at Nashville Super Speedway. But you know what I never smash? Safety rules. Racing's all about control, and the same goes for life on the road. So use your melon and don't mix drinking and driving. It's like trying to race with a busted engine. Be a pit crew hero. And if you've had a few, pass the keys to a sober friend, because we're all racing toward a safer Tennessee, and we want you there at the finish line.
big. Swallow me whole. I couldn't see and it smelled bad in that hell, all those fathoms below. To the roots of the mountains looming over me, go for what seemed like eternity. I lay there in a tangle, my flesh is giving up. Spirit said never in a bold and reckless laugh, in a city and world that groans on my behalf, till my mind can live just a little, and a little is enough. I surrendered my attention to that all-consuming
Smoking tobacco accounts for 3 of every 10 fire deaths in the United States.
Tullahoma Fire Department, Tullahoma Fire Department, need you en route to a structure fire, 202 Main Street, heavy smoke showing. Neighbors advise child trapped inside.
Lighters, matches, and associated smoking paraphernalia are the leading cause of preschooler fire deaths. We as firefighters know that most structure fires can be prevented.
I've got one.
Command, this is primary search. We have a victim. Need EMS to meet us at the front door.
Please help us to give you a fighting chance. This can be prevented. Contact the Tullahoma Fire Department for a free home safety inspection.
What's a Tennessee vacation? It starts off like any road trip, and then, boom, adventure and thrills everywhere you look, which happens to be some of the most beautiful scenery in the country. Music here, history there, and all kinds of green in between. Come relax and unwind, or bring the crowd for some stargazing, or stargazing. Whatever you do, come hungry and expect an awesome soundtrack. It's all right here in Tennessee. We're playing your song. For a free vacation guide, visit tnvacation.com.
Come on. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Woo. You're not gonna get it all right. Just make sure you nail the big stuff. Like making sure your kids are in the right seat for their age and size.
Yeah.
Get it right at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
A black cat.
Okay, this is a test.
What is it? What's the question?
We got 3 minutes, and we just closed this show about 15 minutes ago at the wrong time.
That's
so
okay.
We're going to see if you remember anything that we said. We're just going to sit here and not say anything for 3 minutes and see if you can fill the bill. You think they can? Hey, here we go.
No. Are we just sitting here?
Well, yeah. Y'all remember that one? It was funny, wasn't it? Yeah, I thought it was funny, too. You remember that one, don't you, Peggy?
I think so.
Yeah, it was good. It was good. You know what? I did a thing for South Jackson Goes Country. I've emceed the South Jackson Goes Country show. For those of y'all who don't know about that, it's a show that Peggy did, started 45 years ago, to raise money when South Jackson Civic Center, now South Jackson Performing Arts Center, took over the building down there. And so as part of an MC's job, sometimes things don't go the way they're planned.
Right.
Sort of like right now. And so
you have to
kill time. Somebody will say, go out there and kill time. Well,
is that what we're doing?
Well, yeah, sort of. And so I took a clock that was hanging on the wall at the old studio.
I remember that.
And a gun. And I went out there and put that clock up on a stand. And I walked around, I looked at that clock, and I walked over and I pulled a gun out of my pocket, and I pointed that gun at that clock. And I looked at the audience and said, you know what I'm doing, don't you? They sent me out here to kill time. And I said, but the thing is, if I kill time, the next time they want me to buy time, there won't be no time.
There won't be no time to buy.
So I can't kill time because I might need to add time later on.
Right.
And so I went through a whole bunch of rigmarole, sort of like we're doing right now.
Yeah, just to get through the space.
To kill time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We love you. See you next time.